do this? Do you want to like have conversation? Or do you want me to just like say things for a little while?
Just say things.
Say things.
So we got Cam right here. Say hi, Cam.
Hi, guys.
So Cam, you work for Lincoln.
I work for Lincoln Electric, yes, sir.
What do we got right here?
So this is the Lincoln Electric collaborative robot. It's a obviously a Fanuc robot coupled with a Lincoln Electric R450 power wave. Cobots are starting to be a pretty significant presence in the scene of industrial manufacturing. In a lot of places, we haven't typically seen automation, whether it's smaller job shops, places with lower volume and higher mix of products, places with limited floor space, or just places that haven't been into automation and are kind of scared to jump into the traditional automation like we have over here, just from a learning perspective. Cobots are easy to use, easy to program. This package, for example, is obviously completely portable, mobile. You can move it through a 36-inch door, so anywhere in the shop that you might need it, move it to where the work is, get it out of the way when you don't need it. We can do it on the cart, we can take it off the cart, and you can put it on a tooling table, say in one of your welding, your existing welding booths. We can do air-cooled torches like this, we can do water-cooled, we can do aluminum applications with a push-pull setup. Configurations are super flexible, they deploy really quick, so typically, once it hits the shop floor, within 4 to 6 hours, we're up and running. An operator is pretty much completely trained on programming, so usually a few follow-up calls, but pretty quickly they're off and running once we get these things on the floor.
Sounds pretty sweet, right? It's no surprise we've seen a growing interest in cobot technology. More and more customers are pulling the trigger on employing cobots for their own production. In just a bit, we'll hear what some of these customers have to say about their experience. But first, I asked Cam what he thought our customers might have to say about their recent cobot purchase.
I think they'll be surprised how quickly we turn it on and get running, and then the next thing will be how simple it is to use. A normal learning curve on something like a traditional robot is a few weeks of programming, lots of learning, some intimidated operators, but once this is on the floor and someone has some time to play with a tablet, it's just easy to use. People aren't scared to touch it and become comfortable with it, ready to use it every day.
How difficult was it to train someone on this cobot?
A matter of how many hours Lincoln had in their YouTube channel.
Yeah.
We sat our welder down and said, here, watch these. He watched them, and then once we had the cobot here that he could go play with it, he just re-watched them as he had the cobot. That was how easy it was.
So how long did it take you to figure out how to program this guy?
A couple hours.
Been around the automation robotic welding for about 20 years. And just to see the cobot and the ease of programming, that was the huge selling point for us. The first part that we programmed on there, we have what we call a top and a bottom frame. They all get welded together in the end, but we do them in subcomponents. So the first part we programmed was a bottom frame because it just had a lot more welding and everything involved with it. Once we got that program dialed in, we had our welder set up to weld the tops. So as it was welding the bottoms, he was welding the tops, and they're just coming off in pairs.
Yeah, he basically took two jobs and slammed them into the top.
It's not here to replace you, it's just another tool for you to use. It came down to purity because we have that relationship. One of the big selling points was having purity, Lincoln, everybody right here where we could just get that service if we need it. We're not experts in it, and if something goes wrong with it, we want to be able to get on the phone and get somebody over here right away.
Between Cam, between Eric, between Brett, every time we got a problem, you guys are right on top. It did everything and more we expected it to, yeah. To the point that we lost it.
Yeah, immediately.
Team members often have the myth stuck in their head that if the company is bringing in any type of automation, they're trying to push me out the door. In order to continue to be competitive, and maintain the people that they have and to continue to offer new opportunities, that's the next step. It's interesting, I think we're starting to see the industry as a whole start to shift. The baby boomers that are starting to step away and retire And then some of the younger generation that is a little bit more open-minded to getting creative, it fits extremely well with that mindset.
Not to bash our other tools that we've bought, but the learning curve on the Cobot was far and away the shortest learning curve.
That was quite evident from the first day demo that this is going to be a super simple, quick learning curve.
I think I have a pretty unique perspective on it because I programmed a normal FANUC Lincoln Weld cell before. That being said, the interfaces come so far. We got a handful of guys in the shop that we hired on that have, they've been welding for 3 months, tops. And I brought them over and like, hey, check this out, watch, this is how this works. And those guys can grab that robot and absolutely run that robot with 2 hours of looking at it and playing with it. The footprint of that robot is such a plus for us. We're cramped for size in that room. Being able to grab that robot and say, hey, we were making this part, now we need to make this other part. We can unpin it from the table, move it over to a different fixture, make these parts on day 3, and day 4, 5, and 6, unpin, move back over, and hit go. And to be able to move the arm from thing to thing to thing makes so much sense on our end because we're small and we need to be flexible. People using it being, oh, I'm afraid of this technology. I don't want to crash the robot. It's really hard to crash the robot. When you crash a weld cell yellow FANUC arm, you break things. It wrecks everything. It wads up the gun. It breaks the fixture because it's a robot and it doesn't know to stop. This, you stand in front of it. It crashes into you and you go, oh, dang, wrong spot. You bump the gun into something, it goes and bumps the gun, and it doesn't bend anything, it doesn't break your fixturing, it doesn't mess something up. You lose that fear, and now you can just go, and you can then learn, and your own learning curve becomes, well, now we've got it figured out, how creative we're going to be.
That's pretty sweet.
Excited to look back 6 months from now and go, we didn't really foresee that we were going to be able to do that. And look at how well it's working now.
Look at that video we made. That's all we were doing. Now look what we're up to.
It's going to be hard to take little snippets out of that. Like, I feel like everything you guys said is really, really good.
Play.
Yeah.